Okay. So we're on gross pay right now. We're skipping minimum wage just for a day. We'll go back to it on Monday. So gross pay. Is the total amount you are paid before deductions are taken out of your paycheck? Raise your hand if you have ever received a paycheck before and you see that like they took out stuff for like taxes, that kind of stuff. Okay. So in that situation, it's a surprising amount that they take out for taxes. They also will take out stuff for if you have like health insurance through them. There's a variety of things they might take out of your paycheck. I think I lose... to deductions, I think I lose about a third of my paycheck every time. And that's because that goes towards other stuff, like paying my taxes ahead of time, helping pay for my health insurance, my retirement, that kind of stuff, which is okay. So that's the only definition we're going to write, but what we're going to do together is we're going to start this worksheet together, which is not very tough. There are basically what we're going to be doing. I know it starts at number 3 and I meant it to. We're going to try a few problems here. There's 3 through 9, 10 through 13, 14 through 16. So how about we try, let's try number 4. We'll try number 7. And 14, 15, and 16. Now, do you guys remember me telling you that this class is very easy when it comes to math? Like the math problems we're doing are very easy. These are very real life skills, but the math problems we're doing are going to be very easy. How do you show your work on these worksheets? You just write down the math you're putting into your calculator, okay? And if you're like, but that's a waste of time, that's how you show your work in this class. And again, these homework assignments take like 10 minutes tops. So I feel like you have the time to do it, so I'm going to model that for you now. All right, we're going to start with number 4. Marita usually earns $114.75 per week working weekdays at a movie theater. Last week, she earned $179.63 because she worked all day Saturday. How much did she earn last Saturday? I know this is simple, but what are you thinking?
What math we're doing?
Yeah, what math are you going to do? Colin.
179.63 minus 114.75.
Right, because she normally makes that much, so then we can find out how much you earn on a Saturday. There is really no reason, guys, to be doing this math by hand, unless you really love subtraction by hand, so I would go get a calculator for this. See how easy it was to show my work for that problem? So simple. Why do you think she made so much more on Saturday than the rest of the week? Yeah?
Because nobody likes working at times.
That's true. And when people don't like working at times, they sometimes pay more. Yeah?
Probably worked all day because she didn't have school.
Right, maybe she worked all day. And if she works weekdays, then maybe... And it doesn't say... Does it say that she works every weekday? No. Maybe she works like Tuesday, Thursday evenings, and she works for like 3 hours, where on Saturday she put in like 8 hours or something. Things could be very different there. All right. Next up, we're jumping to number 7. Lou has a part-time job in a restaurant. Stay with me now. Don't just sit there and do the rest of the worksheet. Okay? You follow me. Okay, you can go to the rest of the worksheet in a bit. Lou has a part-time job in a restaurant. He earns $69.38 a day when he cooks and $56.63 a day when he busses tables. Last week he bussed tables 2 days and cooked 1 day. How much did he earn? What's the math we're going to do to figure this out? Somebody raise their hand and let me know. Sawyer. Okay, so you're saying that he bussed tables two. Okay, so this is him cooking 1 day. That's 69.38, right?
Yeah.
That's cooking. And what I'm going to write instead is 2 times 56.63. Although what Sawyer said would work, you could just take 56.63 twice and add them together. Go ahead and you can put this all in your calculator at once. You don't even have to do it in steps. Make sure that your answer has a dollar sign on it. Your work doesn't need to, but your answer definitely does. These are story problems, which means that they have a story answer. You always have to have a label. And when it's money, a dollar sign is good enough. What'd you guys get?
$182.64.
Perfect. Okay. Everybody like, oh, this is not so bad at all. Cool. Back side when you're ready. All right, let's jump to the back. We're going to go to 14, 15, and 16. For this one, you have to look at this chart, which says how much people make who work Saturday mornings in the library. If you're the assistant librarian, you make 62, reading coordinator, 48, reader, 42, and junior reader, 32.50. How much more does an assistant librarian earn each Saturday morning than a junior reader? What do we do for that? We're trying to find the difference between their jobs. Go ahead, Renee.
You subtract 62, or 32.50 from 62.
Right, so make sure in your calculator you put 62 first. 62 minus 32.5. Which is $29.50. The math will get harder in this class than this, but not a lot harder, okay? Like, this is all real life stuff. Carla worked 2 Saturdays as a junior reader and 2 Saturdays as a regular reader. How much did she earn? What should we do for that one?
You gotta do 32.5 times 2 plus 42 times 2.
Good. 32.5 times 2 plus 42 times 2. Remember, you can put that all in your calculator at once. You don't have to do it in different lines. $149?
Yeah.
Okay. Howard worked 1 Saturday.